Now, Second Minister for Finance Indranee Rajah says Singapore's fake news law was used to correct a Facebook post that gave a false impression the government mismanaged public funds. She added that Temasek, GIC and the Monetary Authority of Singapore contribute about 20% of revenues to the national budget.
Ms. Indranee stressed that public funds are managed carefully and prudently. The Protection from Online Falsehoods and Manipulation Act, or POFMA, was invoked twice since it was enacted in October.
Ms. Indranee was speaking on CNA 938 earlier today.
In a Facebook post, Progress Singapore Party member Brad Boyer implied the government is involved in GIC and Temasek's investment decisions. It's a claim that the government says is false and misleading.
Why do you think misperceptions and misconceptions still exist about, GIC and Temasek's investments decisions and the government's involvement with them?
Misconceptions exist when they are actively proliferated.
Yep.
And that was one of the reasons why it was necessary to have protection against online falsehoods.
Mm-hmm. So Ms. Indranee refuted the false statements made in the post and says it was necessary to issue the correction order as the post created a false impression.
First, an allegation that Temasek invested in a debt-ridden company.
Mm-hmm.
Second, an allegation that $4 billion was poorly invested or dumped
yep.
by governing companies and related parties in Andhra Pradesh.
Yep.
And there's the implication that a substantial amount of that went into the Amaravati project. And the third false allegation is that the government controls Temasek's and GLC's investment decisions.
Mm.
So when you put all three together, the overall impression that you get is that public funds are being mismanaged by Temasek and GIC and directed by government. And that's actually not true.
She added that Temasek, GIC and the Monetary Authority of Singapore contribute about 20% of revenues to Singapore's national budget. And over the last 17 years, Temasek's portfolio has tripled to more than $300 billion.
Contrary to the impression created, public funds are being managed carefully and prudently for the public good.
The government website Factually has more information on the falsehoods and misleading statements made. Mr. Boyer has amended his post to include the notice that it contains false statements of fact.